Hello everyone, I believe many of you face a common challenge. When generating videos with character consistency, the degree of consistency often falls short of expectations. This issue primarily depends on two factors. First, the quality of the model itself. And second, the camera angle or perspective. For instance, let's consider the stand-in model, which currently produces the highest quality generations. When generating close-up videos, there are no problems. For example, if we have a reference image of an East Asian beauty, we can generate close-up shots with excellent quality. However, this drawback becomes very apparent once the camera angle pulls back and the shot becomes wider or more distant. For example, look at this video. When the camera angle is further away, the similarity significantly drops, reaching only about 70%. Today, we're going to teach you a method to significantly enhance character consistency. After applying our method, you'll see that the character consistency in the videos is excellent. Even for the more distant shots we just demonstrated, we can achieve a qualitative improvement in character consistency. How do we achieve this? Let's dive in. First, let's reveal the core technologies we use, stand-in and VACE. Stand-in is a character consistency video generation model released by WeChat, capable of maintaining high character consistency. VACE also has similar functionalities. However, neither technology alone can fully meet our requirements. Therefore, my idea is to combine them to achieve the ultimate character consistency we need. I've already provided a very detailed description of stand-in's usage in a previous video, so I won't go into its basic concepts or installation here. Similarly, VACE is not a new technology, so I won't cover its basics in detail. Fortunately, both stand-in and VACE are implemented using the KeyJiwan video extension, so we don't need to install many extensions. Just this one will suffice. Let's look at our first workflow, which is the simplest combination of VACE and stand-in. I've explained its implementation in detail in another video, so you can refer back to it if you need the specifics. It's important to note that in this workflow, VACE is only responsible for motion guidance. It does not impose constraints on character consistency. Here are the key steps for this workflow. Main model loading. We load the 12.1T2V14B model as our main model. LoRA, acceleration is enabled. Model compilation is enabled for faster sampling. Block swapping is enabled. Stand-in loading. We use a LoRA loading node to load our stand-in model. After loading, we connect it to the main model's LoRA input. This injects stand-in into our main model. 5. ACE loader. A crucial node is the VACE loader. We use a VACE model based on 12.1 VACE14B, which is in a modular form. We connect VACE to our main model via the VACE model input, text encoder, and V. These are standard components. Configuration is simple. We mainly set the resolution and total frame count. Guidance, video preprocessing. A guidance video prepares for VACE application. We use a preprocessor to extract its DW open pose, then a resize node aligns the model's resolution with our input. We use the very important one video, VACE encode node. This node is always used when VACE is involved. The pose video is connected to input frames. The output, named VACE MBD, is saved. Combining VACE and stand-in. This part combines VACE and stand-in. We have a stand-in preprocessing process. A YOLO model preprocesses the input character image. This extracts the person's head information. The one video encode node then encodes the character's facial features into the latent space. We use the add stand-in latent node. The stand-in facial information is connected to the IP image latent input. The VACE embed, the generated VACE embedding vector, is connected to the embed node. This node effectively combines VACE and stand-in. The resulting new image embedding vector is saved. Sampling process. The sampling process is straightforward. For layout neatness, the prompt and sampling sections are combined. The prompt is, "Woman is talking in office." The text prompt output is connected to text embedded. The combined VACE and stand-in input is connected to image embedded. Sampling parameters. Since an accelerated model is used, there are only 4 sampling steps. CFG is 1.0. SIFT. Scale factor for classifier-free guidance is 5.0. The sampling algorithm is DPM++_seed, a common algorithm used by KeyJiwan. After decoding, we get the first version of the video. Result: the character's state is only about 70% similar, and the character doesn't look particularly like the reference. How do we solve this problem? We can now add a reference image to VACE to strengthen consistency. Let's look at the second workflow. Its overall structure is identical to the first, but with some adjustments. Fixed seed. The seed is fixed throughout the workflow to ensure consistency in noise generation. We introduce a reference image. This image is interesting because its overall effect is the same as the video's first frame, but with much better character consistency. We'll explain how this image is generated later. We resize this image and connect it to the reference image input in VAC. This method adds another layer of character consistency preservation. On one hand, Stand-in uses facial information to ensure consistency. On the other hand, we also enable VAC's character consistency preservation by connecting this image to VAC's reference image. This effectively enhances character consistency. The generated effect shows some noticeable improvement, but it still might not meet our requirements. So, we'll add a third layer of consistency. We use the One Video VACE start to end frame node. Besides connecting to the reference image to ensure character consistency, we also connect it to the start image. This adds another layer of guidance. Let's look at the generated effect now. It's clearly much better. I've done many tests. For instance, even with a smaller face, using this method significantly improves the overall consistency of the generated video. So, this method is generally effective. Now, let's reveal the answer to a question many of you are concerned about. How is this reference image generated? This uses one of my previous workflows, specifically a face swapping workflow. We use flux context for high precision face swapping. If you're unfamiliar with it, please refer to my other video. I've made some modifications to that workflow, which you can also adjust as needed. I've used a very interesting LoRA called Place It. This LoRA can correct an image to achieve a specific look. Here's how it's done. 1. Take the first frame of your video and place it here. 2. Take your character's reference image and place it here. 3. Pass both through a node called Facelet to align the two faces. You'll notice the face in the character image will rotate to align with the face in the video frame. 4. After alignment, we crop and paste this face, essentially pasting the character's face onto the video frame's character. 5. The final result is an image where the character's face is aligned. We then use the Place It LoRA, which is very simple to use. We set a prompt. Place it. The rest of the workflow is a standard flux context workflow. This allows us to get this specific image. Once this image is used in our video, you'll find that the overall consistency significantly improves. In summary, we achieve this by using a triple face consistency preservation method. This allows us to elevate the consistency of characters that previously didn't look very similar to a new level. I hope this processing method is helpful to everyone. That's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.